टर्पिनॉइड्स आर सेकेंडरी मेटाबोलाइट्स, ये हमने लास्ट सेमेस्टर में भी पढ़ा था बायोसिंथेसिस एंड बायोजेनेसिस में, हमने टर्पिन्स पढ़े थे, टर्पिनॉइड्स पढ़े थे वहां पर. तो दीज आर सेकेंडरी मेटाबोलाइज्ड सिंथेसाइज्ड बाय प्लांट्स, मरीन ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड फंगी बाय हेड टू टेल जॉइनिंग ऑफ isoprene units. This is very important. The head to tail joining of isoprene units is very important in this terpenoids. Terpenoids can also be found in rocks, fossils, and animal kingdoms also. लेकिन इनके जो applications हैं industry में, these are very many different types of applications are there. Like for example, linalool. Yes, studied last year, last semester. Linalool is used in perfume industry. Similarly, citral is used for anti mosquito repellent. तो हमारा good night, all out, morphine वगैरह जो भी आते हैं, वो सारे ही इसमें जो main ingredient होता है, जो जिससे कि mosquitoes भागते हैं, वो होता है ये citral. ये सिट्राल कंपाउंड हमारा ग्रीन टी जो होता है, ग्रीन टी के जो लीव्स होते हैं उससे भी हम एक्सट्रैक्ट कर सकते हैं. तो अगर आपको गुड नाइट वगैरह नहीं भी लगाना हो तो भी ग्रीन टी का जो बॉइल है उससे अगर आप स्क्रब दो एक्सट्रैक्ट, तो दैट विल आल्सो बी एक्टिंग एज ए मॉस्किटो रिपेलेंट और वहां से सारे मॉस्किटोज को लगा देता हूँ. सिमिलरली वी हैव मेंथॉल, artemisinin and used in pharmaceutical industries. Farnesol and juvabion are used in insect juvenile hormones, and there are many different compounds from simple to very complex, like taxol, which is used as anti-cancer drug. This is highly complex molecule taxol, jo aapne last semester mein padha tha iska structure and synthesis aapne padha tha. There are very few labs involved which are able to synthesize taxol. Only about 7 or 8 labs have been successful for synthesizing the taxol. Classification of the terpenoids can be done on the basis of how many isoprene units are present, based on number of isoprene units. We can classify them into different classes. If it is the number of isoprene units, a number of carbons, and the class of terpenoids. Isoprene unit is five carbon compound which is having 2 double bonds, and this is called as a isoprene. Star jo unit yahan pe jo terpenoids mein hota hai wo normally hota hai reduced one. So this will be our isoprene unit, and if there are multiple isoprene units will be present in the terpenoids, we can classify them into as a, if there is one isoprene unit is there, then there are 5 carbon atoms are present, we call it as a hemiterpene, or we call it as a meroterpene. Hemiterpene or meroterpenoid. Meroterpenoids are hemiterpenes. If it is 2 isoprene units are there, then 10 carbon atoms are there. Ek isoprene unit mein 5 carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 carbon atoms. So, दो isoprene unit होंगे तो 10 carbon atoms, and that we call it as a monoterpene. Monoterpenoid. If it is 3 isoprene units are there, then we have 15 carbon atoms. We call it as sesquiterpene. Similarly, 4 carbon atoms पे C20 इट्स 20 कार्बन एटम्स एंड वी कॉल दिस एज ए डाई टर्पिनोइड और डाई टर्पिन्स। फाइव अगर यूनिट तो C25 एंड दिस वी कॉल इट एज सेस्टर टर्पिनोइड्स। एंड अगर सिक्स होंगे तो C30 ट्राई टर्पिनोइड्स। एंड लास्ट वन दैट इज एट अगर होंगे तो वी कॉल इट एज C40 एंड वी कॉल इट एज टेट्रा टर्पिनोइड। इफ देर आर मल्टीपल देन दिस विल बी अ पॉलीमर दैट वी कॉल इट एज ए नेचुरल रबर। नेचुरल रबर इज ऑल्सो मेड अप ऑफ दिस आइसोप्रीन यूनिट्स ओनली but it has a polymerized isoprene units are present. So this is how we can classify the terpenoids into different classes from merterpene or hemiterpene to natural polymers. We can classify them into different categories. Sources of this can be essential oils can be the good source for terpenoids. Sources can be plants. And have marine organisms and fungi can be the sources for this terpenoids. Further, we have structure elucidations. General structure elucidation, we will be looking for gingiberin as an example for terpenoids. We have only one gingiberin whose gingiberin has a molecular formula of C15H24 as it is having 15 carbon atoms, so it is a sesquiterpenoid. It is a sesquiterpenoid. Its structure is is a main ingredient of ginger oil. That is why it is called as gingiberin. यहाँ पे जो structure है इसका इसका molecular formula जो है C15H24. For a normal alkane, which should have a for a 15 carbon atom, we have a formula CnH2n+2. So यहाँ पे 15 carbon atom के लिए 32 hydrogens होने चाहिए थे. We have a 24 hydrogens, so it is 8 hydrogens are less. So our deficiency of hydrogen index is 4. So it will be either 4 double bonds are there or 4 cyclic groups are present over here. So for that, what we can do is that first we can react this with catalytic hydrogenation, that is H2, PT or palladium supported on carbon gives us hexahydro derivative. Hexahydro derivative, which suggests that there are 3 double bonds are present. Three double bonds are present, but there is a hydrogen deficiency index of 4, so it is a mono carbocyclic compound. It is a mono carbocyclic compound, that is one ring is present, one cyclic ring is present in the group. So this is from one test we can conclude this, that it is a monocyclic carbocyclic compound and contains three double bonds are present. Further, the large molecular exaltation exhibited by the gingiberin suggests that there are two double bonds in conjugation, because इसका जो UV spectrum है, this UV spectrum gives lambda max at 260 nanometer. 260 nanometer में इसमें से तीन में से दो डबल बॉन्ड कॉन्जुगेशन में हो सकते हैं, that we can have it. And those two are homoannular diamond. जो हमने लास्ट ईयर में आपने पढ़ा था, so that homoannular dyne or cis dyne, that we can cissoid, we can conclude it over here. Then it formed a when it was treated with sodium ethoxide. It lost one of the double bonds. One of the double bonds was reduced, and when further treated with KMnO4, it gave a dicarboxylic acid. Group that we get it. Further, when it was treated with NaOBr, this was converted into a tricarboxylic acid. Tricarboxylic acid was obtained from here. Gingiberin on ozonolysis yielded levulinic acid and acetone and succinic acid, which were also obtained during the ozonolysis of monocyclic sesquiterpenes bisabolin. So the structure for this will be similar to that of the bisabolin structure. So skeleton इसका जो है वो bisabolin के बराबर का आना चाहिए. Bisabolin का structure हमने last year में पढ़ा था. So from this particular bisabolin का जो structure है उससे और जो dicarboxylic acids with KMnO4 we obtained it. So from that, what we can conclude is that the structure of this is somewhat like this. ये बीटा बिसाबोलिन का जो स्केलेटन है, बिसाबोलिन स्केलेटन, जस्ट उसमें सिर्फ यहाँ पर डबल बॉन्ड्स का डिफरेंस है, बाकी इसमें वेरी मच सिमिलर टू बिसाबोलिन. Further, we have to attribute the stereochemistry for this. Stereochemistry suggests that there are two chiral centers in gingiberin, one acyclic and other cyclic. Acyclic chiral center was correlated to citronellal. With acyclic chiral center, this one, we have two chiral centers at this carbon and at this carbon. So here, this is a cyclic chiral center, and this is an acyclic chiral center. Acyclic chiral center can be attributed to citronellal, which is very much similar to citronellal. While cyclic chiral center to us, it is stereochemically correlated with phenylalanine. This were giving very much similar properties to that. So the overall structure for this can be stereochemically structure for this can be methyl group as a wedge bond. Here the hydrogen is at a, as a wedge bond. That is as a structure for this. Synthesis for gingiberin can be started from 6-methyl, 5-hectene, 6-methyl, 5-hectene, 2-ohm. Sixth position pe methyl group hai, and second position pe we have a carbonyl, and at fifth position we have a double bond. So this pigment reacted with para anisole magnesium bromide, which is NAD reagent, CS3 and GBr. We will get structure as 2CH3. This, when it is heated, therefore here we will have a OH. When heated, it will undergo dehydration. There will be removal of water molecule and double bond yahan par aayega. So we will have double bond. Aromatic ring with 2CH3. Further, this can be reacted with sodium in ethanol and ammonia, liquid ammonia, for giving as Birch reduction. To reduce this aromatic ring, further treated with acid hydrolysis, strong acid. So this ether bond jo hai wo break ho sakta hai, that is HBr mein agar hum treat kare to ether bond ko hum break kar sakte hain. OH double bond. Now this is an enol form, so it can undergo tautomerization. Give us a carbonyl group and now we can react this with methyl magnesium bromide. Here we have a OH. This when treated with anhydrous oxalic acid. Will give us the desired this OH and this H will go. So dehydration will happen and we will have a double bond, which will then be further a double bond to this isomerize over, and we will have conjugated double bond. Yeah, wait, our methyl group. This will double bond. So this will be the gingiberin structure. So this is how we can obtain gingiberin, which will be further reduced. हमें ये double bond यहाँ से reduce करना है, so stereoselective reduction of this double bond. Will give us the required gingiberin. So this is how we can synthesize gingiberin, and this was for terpenes.